With TV supporting Northern Online.
Hello, I'm Miles, and this is the Ribble Valley Jazz Festival. We're watching Northern Online broadcasts, but we just wanted to let you know there's a festival going on this weekend in the beautiful Ribble Valley in Clitheroe and surrounding villages. Kicking off this Thursday night at Holmes Mill with Alan Barnes, and Friday night here at the Atrium up at Clitheroe Castle, and it's a superb venue. We've got Ubunye coming here on Friday. That means oneness. There's also a bit of silly hat activity going on Saturday evening up at the Clitheroe Cricket Club with Pericopes. I think they're in the country, they're all coming over from Europe. So we're looking forward to getting a bit silly Saturday night. And what else are we looking forward to? Sunday, we're looking forward to Matthew Housel, Mammal Hands in the grand venue. We love it. I hope you come to the festival, but in the meantime, remember, it's always better to see jazz in person at superb venues than on a video.
Lunchtime. We're at Thursday. We've got some guitar masters today. Oh, thank you very much, sir.
So we're just in the corn exchange at the moment, and just listen to this reverb. Perfect for musicians.
It's a lovely, lovely space to play in. Actually, we've played here together, haven't we? I think maybe.
No, maybe not.
No, we haven't. But we will do. We'll do that. It's a lovely place to play in. Done it. Played here a few times. You get a pan actually there, Nigel, of the of the space. Yeah.
Thanks Nigel.
Yeah. Lovely. And then back to Jay Frisco. Thanks, yeah. At Jay Frisco Music. Tweet us if you're listening in today. Who are Jay Frisco? You must be wondering by now. We're on day three of the old Jay Frisco takeover. So tell me, who are Jay Frisco?
We are an improvisational trio. We create genre fluid art and music, and we met at Leeds College of Music.
So we met here in the North, Jazz North, in Leeds. We came together from all over the country actually, and we love it here, don't we?
It's great.
We're having a great time.
So you're probably wondering what instruments we play. I play keyboards and vocals.
I play guitar.
And I play the saxophone.
So today we've got guitar masters. So Megan, do you want to talk about who's playing?
So first we've got Stuart McCallum, who is an amazing guitarist who actually taught me in my third year at Leeds College of Music. It's emotional, it's beautiful music. That is his selling point, is creating beautiful soundscapes with his guitar. We've also got John Bailey, Nick Svarc, and Mike Walker.
Guitar!
We'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you. So my name's Stuart McCallum, play guitar, I'm also a composer and producer. This ensemble's based in Manchester. I had an album came out in 2011 on the Name label, which was called Distilled. And we've been playing that music and then the music from the follow-up album, which is called Distilled Live. That's what we're playing tonight. So I guess we've been together for 3 years, I suppose. But I've played with the drummer and the bass player a lot more than that. This is a relatively new project. Tonight I'm playing with, it's a trio, guitar, bass, drums. We use laptop to trigger samples, and then we've got a string quartet called the Real Strings. Thank you. the sound of the band would be, well, it's got a number of influences. So, I mean, it has jazz, the influence of jazz, the main influence that jazz has on it is that there's improvisation in the music. There's also classical instrumentation, obviously, with the strings. We use a laptop to trigger harp, celeste, horn sections, and electronics. So there's like the electronica kind of influence. My guitar playing, which uses a lot of delays and kind of atmospherics, and then beats from the drums and bass lines kind of influence more from, I guess, DJ culture. I guess I always try and fit the music into like the cracks between genres. So if I feel as a writer that it's sounding too much like that, I'll change tack a little bit and try and avoid those kind of immediate reference points. I don't think I chose music, I think music chose me. And when I turned about 15, just something happened and that was it. I was doing music and there wasn't any choice in the matter really. I think I'm interested in writing music that represents now, you know, and not that has influences from music of the past, but it also looks forward, I guess. So, you know, I'm really into working in the studio and that environment, you know, and the kind of level of detail in electronics that you can get into. And it's, a lot of it's sort of subtleties, you know, but all those kind of subtleties that you bring together make an identifiable whole, I guess. We'll be right back. Well, I'm always writing new music. I've got various different projects that as outlets for my music, so I don't feel like I have to try and force a composition into a particular. If I just had one project, then I would disregard some of the stuff that I'm writing because it wouldn't massively fit into the project. So. They think, oh, I'd really like to listen to that again. I'd like to explore it and get deeper into it, because there's a lot of layers in the music, and if you can listen to it kind of on in the background, and it will be a nice soundtrack to your life. But you can also get into it deeply, and there's a lot of work gone into it, and there's a lot of different subtleties that you'll pick up on if you listen to it in a closer way.
Hi, I'm Matt Anderson, and I'm from Castleton, a little village in the North Yorkshire Moors. The North has been incredibly influential in my playing and writing, both from when I was growing up in the kind of rural communities of North Yorkshire and experiencing the folk music and the community music going on there, through to my studies at Leeds College of Music, and later on being part of the great music scene in Leeds and benefiting from the support of organisations like Jazz North. My new album, Rambling, is coming out on the 25th of May, and it's very inspired by the sounds and the landscapes of the North, where I grew up. Got a little copy here. And hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much.
With TV supporting Northern Online. As a fellow broadcaster, I'm really happy to offer like 1 year of Quest TV to support your good initiative like Northern Online. I'm really curious about that, and please have this 1 year subscription of Quest TV supporting Northern Online. Quest TV.